Hello everyone, my name is Pranshu and welcome to my channel. So in the previous video, we saw the different softwares that we can use for robot designing. If you haven't watched that video yet, click right here to check it out. So as discussed in that video, we are now going to design our robot in Fusion 360. I hope you have downloaded and installed Fusion 360 on your PC. If not, then click the link in the description to get it for yourself. The robot that we are going to design in this video is a basic two-wheeled robot that we are going to use for ROS simulation. And later, we will be building a real robot similar to that design, something like this. This video is a part of a tutorial series that focuses on making an autonomous room mapping and navigation robot using ROS. The robot is capable of generating a map of your room, which then you can use to tell the robot to go at a specific location in your room. And it will navigate to that specific point autonomously, avoiding all the obstacles. If you haven't watched the previous videos of this series, click right here to check out the playlist. And if you don't want to miss out on upcoming videos, make sure you are subscribed to my channel and ring the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. So let's have a sneak peek of what we are about to do. This is a very compact three-layer robot design specifically made so that it can be equipped with all necessary electronics which are needed for room mapping using ROS. I have used very minimal electronic components that are required for ROS in this robot to make it beginner as well as budget friendly. So if you wish to upgrade your robot with a better microprocessor or a better LiDAR or camera system, you are free to do so. But then, you have to edit your design accordingly. We will talk more about it in later videos. Right now, let's focus on the designing part and get started. So here we are on the home screen of Fusion 360. You can see all the tools on the toolbar at the top. Beside that, you can see that we are in the design workspace. And below it is the list of all sketches, bodies, joints, and every other component of your design. The first thing we are going to do is set our preferences. The z-axis in ROS simulation and visualization points in the upward direction. However, it's in the outward direction in Fusion 360. But to avoid misalignment of your robot in ROS, make sure the default modeling orientation is z-up, and also make your default units to mm. Press OK to save it and we are done. Now you can orbit around your model by pressing Shift key along with scroll button. And you can pan around it by pressing just the scroll button. To manage all our design files properly, we are now going to create a project. For that, open the data panel and click on New Project. Name the project whatever you want. To know why I am naming the project as Oro, check out the YouTube highlights on my Instagram page. Also follow me if you like my content. Once the project is created, double click to open it and save your current design files in it. You can view the name and the version of the design at the top. Each time you save the design, a new version is created. You can also switch between versions easily if you wish to make any changes. Now let's create our first sketch. Click on the sketch icon on the top left corner and then select the plane on which you want to sketch. I will create a circle over here with diameter 120 mm. You can directly type the diameter in the given field. Let's see it from the top and save the design. As soon as you save the design, you can see a thumbnail of the design is updated in the data panel. Now I want to make inserts for the wheel. For that, I am going to construct a center point rectangle over the circle. And there we have the sketch of the base of our robot ready. Now I will select the different parts of the sketch using Ctrl and left mouse button and then extrude it by pressing E and then typing the thickness that I want, that is 2 mm. And this is how you can create 2D drawings into 3D bodies in Fusion 360. Now let's create one more sketch on the top of the base for the brass spacers. The spacers will be hexagonal, so go into the polygon and select circumscribed polygon. Select the point where you want to make the hexagon and make it just like we made the circle, with input as the radius of circumscribed circle, that is 2.5 mm. Now click the hexagonal face and extrude up to 40 mm. But in the operation, select new body instead of join. And now we have two bodies. One is the base plate and second one is the brass spacer. Now instead of making separate sketches and spacers, we will mirror the existing spacer. To do that, click on the create option and then select mirror. In the pattern type, select bodies and then select the standoff which we made earlier.
the plane along which we want to mirror the body. Then click on OK and you can see the body is mirrored on the opposite side as well. Now repeat the same procedure with two bodies this time on the perpendicular plane to have both the standoffs on the other side as well. You can also pin some tools to toolbars which you use regularly. To do so, simply navigate to the tool that you want to pin and select the pin to toolbar option. Let's create the second layer of our robot. To do so, click on the sketch tool and select the top face of one of the standoff. This creates a sketch plane on that specific height. Now I will make a circle with diameter 120 mm on that plane and then extrude it to a height of 2 mm. Don't forget to choose the option as a new body while extruding. Now we will copy paste the second layer to create a similar third layer over it. Now we will specify the material properties of our bodies. When you right click on any of your body and go to the properties, you can see that the default physical material is aluminium. However, I am going to create all these parts using acrylic sheets. So to change the material, right click on the body and go into the physical material section. Select the desired material and drag and drop it over your body. We will also specify the material for the spacers, which is brass. So now when you go back to properties, you can see the physical material of the body is set to acrylic. But I don't quite like the plastic gray color of the acrylic. So to change that, right click on the body and go to the appearances section. Here I can see all the available colors and finishing for the material I have selected. I will choose the one which I want to use. You can download it if it's not already present on your system and then drag and drop it over your body. And look, you have a clean looking black and golden robot. Now let's add some joints to our robot. So if you take up any part and move it by pressing M, you can see that it moves separately, leaving all adjoining parts behind. If you import this model into simulation, it will fall into pieces. So to avoid that, let's add joints. Let's move the remaining parts upward so that we have a clear space below for working. So now to add joints, first we need to convert all the bodies into components. Right click on the bodies and click create components from bodies. And you can see all your bodies are now turned into a list of components. Now go back to the toolbar and select joints from the assembly menu. You can also directly press J to activate joints. Click on the surface of the part you want to join. And then similarly select the parent body you want this part to be connected to. Your part will then snap automatically. You can also change the position of the joint by using these arrows. And there you have a rigid joint. So if you now move the base, standoff will move along with it. Similarly, we will add rest of the joints too. To fix the upper layer of the robot, connecting them to just one standoff is sufficient. And now you can see if we move the base, rest of the parts move along with it. Also, we can rename all the parts so that we don't get confused later. Now it's time to add all the models of our electronic components to our project. Instead of designing each and every component by yourself, visit GrabCAD.com. GrabCAD is the largest online community for designers. You can find 3D models of almost anything over here. So firstly, let's search for Raspberry Pi and see what we get. You can download any model you want because as I said in the previous video, Fusion 360 supports all file formats. I like this one, so let's download it by signing into our GrabCAD account and the download will start automatically. Once the download is complete, you can go into Fusion 360 and upload your model into your project folder. You can open multiple models simultaneously on Fusion 360 in different tabs. So now let's get back to our robot design and add the Raspberry Pi into it simply by dragging and dropping. Now as you can see, the color of Raspberry Pi is not proper over here. We cannot change it in this model as Raspberry Pi is linked to its original model that is denoted by the chain icon beside its name. So to change it, let's open up Raspberry Pi model and go into appearances of its body. In that you can see materials and colors that are already used on the Raspberry Pi. For example, the yellow color is used for the hole. So now we will select first faces because we want to apply the color on just one face and not the whole Raspberry Pi. And then select the green color and drag and drop it over the face we want. And there we have it, a nice looking Raspberry Pi. Save the model and let's get back to our robot design. Here you will see a warning which states that all the linked components are not up to date. Just click on it and it will update all the components on its own. And there we have an updated Raspberry Pi. This tool is really helpful while working on projects with multiple collaborators working on different designs. Let's join this to our robot just like we did for our previous components. You can edit the joints even after it's being made by going to the joint section and clicking edit joint. I will add a buffer space for the pins and the SD card which is at the bottom side of the Raspberry Pi. Similarly, I will add rest of the electronic components too and get back to you once I am done. Here I am adding a L29A10 motor driver along with a DC buck converter which converts 12 volts into 5 volts which is suitable for Raspberry Pi. I am also adding lithium ion cell holder above Raspberry Pi that will give us 11 to 12 volts. And to charge these cells, I am adding a lithium ion charger module. Over the top of the robot is an RP LiDAR A1 which provides a 360 degree of laser scan with no blind spots which will be very useful for room mapping. And under the second layer is an inertial measurement unit to know the orientation of our robot. Now let's slow down here a little bit as we are going to add motors and wheels with revolute joints. Here I am using an N20 micro metal gear motor with an encoder to get precise odometry values for our robot. We'll fix them to the chassis as every other joint we did and also add wheels and join them over the shaft. You can flip the joint so that the complete wheel is recessed into the robot design. But as you can see, we have made rigid joints over here. So to make it a revolute joint, right click on the joint and then click edit joint. Into the motion, select the revolute icon and the joint will now be converted to revolute joint. We will do the same on the other side too. Now let's state the origin of our robot as that will state how it will spawn in our raw simulation. As you can see, our robot is below the origin point. So what we will do is lift our robot so that the wheel exactly touches the ground plane. We can zoom into it to see it more precisely. And now we are almost done with our robot design. But our robot can't just balance on two wheels. For that, we'll now add caster wheels. For making caster wheels, start a sketch on the bottom part of the robot and draw a circle. I am drawing it with a diameter of 15 mm. Close the sketch and extrude the part by pressing E, then selecting the sketch surface and then the ground plane so that the caster reaches exactly at the ground height. Make sure your operation is new body and now you have a cylinder. To make it smooth like caster, we will add fillet using F. Select the edge you want to add fillet and then use the arrow to change the radius of fillet. As our cylinder has diameter 15 mm, we'll set the radius of fillet to 7.5 mm to get a smooth dome. And there we have our caster. Just like all other parts, join this to our robot base too using rigid joint. Also copy the same caster to the backside of your robot so that it doesn't tumble backwards. And that's it. We are done with our complete robot design. And this is how it looks.
So here we are done with our robot designing. I hope you found this process useful and learned something new. If yes, then don't forget to give a thumbs up to this video. In the next video, we will see how we can animate this model and create high definition images as well as video renders from Fusion 360. We'll also have a look at the mobile app of Fusion 360 and see how we can use it in our day-to-day life. If you don't want to miss out on that video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload it. That was it for this video, guys. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next one. Peace.